welcome to my channel. Well, in this episode, we're taking a look at this, the Toyota FJ Cruiser. Now, I did mention in a previous episode that I have a lot of items to review that are not drones. So I'm going to squish them in maybe once a week. So you'll see something not really drone related, but so awesome that I know you're going to want to get this for Christmas for yourself or somebody else. So let's take a look at this here Toyota FJ Cruiser. Just a few things to pass on. I'm just reading the outside of the box. I've never opened this before, so it is an injected, molded, hard body, blah, 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 blah. Nothing exciting there. It does have lights. It says it has multifunction lights, so headlights, fog lights, tail lights, everything else. We're going to check that out. One thing I think is pretty neat is it has, where did I read it? Over here. It says it has, we are happy to announce that this cruiser's wheels match all the tires of the same scale Toyota FJ Cruiser. So I guess the wheels look identical if you own one. I don't own a Toyota FJ Cruiser. I always wanted to get one, but I couldn't afford them. They're darn expensive. Even today in the used market, these are expensive real vehicles. So if any of you out there have one, post a comment below and tell me what you think of it, because I always wanted one of these, like a real one. Now, I've never seen the one in here, so I'm opening it for the first time right now. Oops. Anyways, so it comes in this really nice case, and a lot of the FMS cars, that's one of the things they're known for, is they make pretty realistic vehicles that a lot of people love, and they put them all in styrofoam cases for collectors so that they stay quite good for many years, and then you pull them out in the future and they're a collector's item. So let's pull off this top and see what we have inside. So here we go. I'll show you. You'll see it first. I'll just hold it like this. Watch it go falling out. Oh, I see it falling out already. Let's see. So what do we have there? I'm looking in the monitor. So I see a user manual. I see our little baby here. There's the controller. And I'm assuming the battery's inside. It looks realistic as I'm looking at it here. So let me pull this out. See what else we got. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me just push it over here. It does look pretty sweet. The only thing that I can tell right away, you can see what I'm doing? The only thing I can tell right away is it does not have oil-filled shocks, because when you buy a car with oil-filled shocks, there's a dampening system. So when you push down, they don't pop up really fast. These are spring shocks. And that's to be expected on something of this price range, you know, this sort of look to it. I'm going to show you close-ups of this vehicle as I talk and look at the parts, because I'm seeing it for the first time. So looking at the entire body right off the bat, just like a lot of the FMS vehicles, they actually put mirrors in the mirror. So the little side mirrors are mirrors. Do these ones move? Nope. Door handles. These doors do not open, but when I look inside, I can see everything is quite detailed. I'm sure if I owned one of these Toyotas, it would look like that. And I can see all four seats plus the back. I don't think the back's as detailed as the front. There is a windshield wiper here. Oh, in the rear, there's a windshield wiper that moves back and forth. That's pretty sweet. What about the front ones? Do they move? Yeah, they do. So I can move the front windshield wipers as well. Snorkel on the front, roof rack, and you have lights up front. It is going to be proportional steering. On the back, squishy tires. The tires are super squishy, so they're really grippy. Maybe that's what they were talking about. And you even have a license plate on the rear. Now, they did say there's aluminum rails underneath, so I want to see that. So what's aluminum? Oh, that's what they're talking about. I think they're talking about the frame. The center frame system is aluminum on the sides. At least it must be what they're talking about when they say aluminum rails for rock rails and stuff. Normally, rock rails are here on the side. But maybe I read it wrong. It is a four-wheel drive. It does have a brushed motor. And if you're wondering about the motor, let me read it here. It says a high-torque, oversized 55T brushed motor. It says, with the included battery that's in here, you'll get 30 minutes of runtime and range. Doesn't show on here, but all of these vehicles, the range is always like maybe 100 meters. So for something this small, it's obviously powered correctly, and it is a crawler vehicle. It's not a race vehicle. I will say, I just keep looking at it. It looks so detailed, and I'm sure anybody out there who owns one of these, the real thing, you're probably looking at it and going, that is really detailed. I gotta get one. Now, like all of these vehicles, when they come, they have these stickers on them that say, remove me now if you wanna use me. So I'm gonna get rid of these. Good detailing in the front. The grill is really nice. The lights are exactly where they should be. The Toyota badging there. It is licensed, so that's why you pay a little bit more of a premium. It is really nicely done. This will obviously be a collector for me. They put the snorkel on it. I've never seen any of these FJ Cruisers driving around with the snorkel. I know people add them as aftermarket, but I guess the part of the world you live in is probably where you would use the snorkel more. If you're out in the outback driving around with these things, going underwater and stuff, like deep in water. So under here will be our battery and our electronics. So let's open the hood. There we go. So I got the hood open and let me check out what's inside. So I see the battery is right there. So the battery is a 7.4 volt at 380 milliamp hours. There's an on and off switch under the hood, which is a nice touch because if you leave the battery unplugged in, you just turn the switch off. You can see all the electronics there, which leads me to believe it's not waterproof. It's water resistant, splash proof, because there's a lot of electronics sticking right there. And I can see capacitors and everything else. So transistors, that can't be waterproof. I don't see any coating on it. So it's water resistant. It does come with a goodie bag. Whoa, hey, there's two batteries in this thing. So let me tell you what I received in mine. And I think they all come like this because it's just a standard kit. So mine came with two batteries, so I have two batteries, so that's 1 hour of runtime. The tool made out of metal to take the wheels off. The charger, it's a USB charger for the LiPo batteries. You have the instruction booklet, and what is this thing here? What does it say? Note, if it is not in use for a long time, unplug and take off the battery to prevent battery leakage. And of course, it's totally spelt incorrectly. So that's pretty cool. Don't leave your battery in forever and ever. Let's pull out the remote. I'm gonna have to add batteries to this because they are not included. So the remote's a good size. This flips up, I can see it right now. This flips up and inside here, we have our on off switch, trim controls, everything else, and our buttons for our lights are all in here. So let me put batteries in the bottom and we'll get this working and test it out. So like all these remotes, it's gonna take four batteries and these are AAA batteries. So put four in and we'll be good to go. There we go, we have a light and everything else. And now I'm gonna move this paper and everything else out of the way because I'm gonna smash into stuff. And now I'm gonna put one of these batteries in. Okay, batteries in, I'm gonna turn the power switch on, the little switch here, see what happens. So we have power and I can steer it. All right, so let's close the hood and let's see how it drives here. Let me see. Should be crawler mode, so we should be able to go nice and slow. Oh yeah, so I can go super slow. And of course, if I saw a dinosaur attacking me, I could speed up. So let me try this way. You will probably want to see how fast it is. It's not that bad. That's full speed. I have plenty of time to grab it. All right, let's try those headlights and see, because I have no headlights working here. See that? But I think I have signal lights. Yeah, I got signal lights. All right, for the lights, I'm going to stick this. Can I even fit it up here? This is like a lift hoist thing here. So there we go. That's the best I could do. All right, so on here, it's got this really cool thing. It says, if you want to use the lights, I had to read the instructions. If you want to use the lights, you must put your controller in B mode. So I'm in B mode. I still have full control. I can try it here. I can make it move. You can still drive around, steer, everything else. And then it says hit the LED button. So the first mode, you have basically just the signal lights. I don't know if I can do this because, oh, there we go. So it still works. Okay. So first mode, I have signal lights and that is front and back, which I've already shown you. Then you have headlights. You have low beams. So there's low beams and you have signal lights with low beams, and then you have high beams, I think it is. There's high beams, signal lights with high beams. And then you should just have, I don't know. Oh, four-way flashers. So that's four-way flashers. And then you should have everything off. Now on the rear, what you have is, I thought you had signal lights on this, but it looks like you have brake lights and stuff like that. So here, let me just show you. There you go, there's the brakes. So I have brakes on happening here. There we go. Now, since you have all the controls on here, which are standard for any type of remote control vehicle, there is an undocumented feature that a lot of us in the RC community use, and I'll show you. I call it driving slow climbing mode. So you go like this. All I have to do is I have to just adjust my throttle. So I'm gonna hit the plus button. I think it should work. And this thing here should go into like a climbing mode. There we go. See, not touching a thing. So you could drive it. It will just go at that super slow speed and you can drive it along a course or whatever without touching the throttle, so you can keep it constant. You can speed it up or slow it down too. I'll put a show you down here. If I add more to it, I'll just hit the plus. So I'm increasing it. And to get rid of that, just hit the minus. All it is a trim control. So in the RC hobby with crawlers, a lot of people play with the trim controls so that you don't have to feather the throttle. You can then concentrate on where it's going. Now this is a 1/18 scale RC 4x4, and I'm wondering how it's gonna perform outside in grass, you know, dirt, rocks that are quite large. So let's take it outside and give it a try. Check this out. All right, so you've seen it outside. It's pretty darn decent. It's pretty cool. I think people could have a lot of fun with this, especially if you own one of these vehicles or have owned one in your life, or you're like me, you never could afford one. They're so expensive. So you've got yourself the little 1/18 scale unit. You can drive it around and put it up on a shelf and everybody thinks it looks really cool because they immediately recognize it. So I'm going to put links below. Go check it out. If you want to know anything about the specifications or anything else about this vehicle, just, you know, post a comment below and I'll get back to you. I have an awful lot of RC crawlers, RC racers, everything, so I can answer your questions for certain. It's pretty good that it comes with two batteries. Check out the price. There'll be a discount below as well. Use the discount code so you can save some dollars and see if it's for you. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I'm gonna have future videos of other little cars and helicopters and planes. Oh, and I got other non-drone things that I have to squish them in at least one per week if I have the time to do it. So stay tuned for those. A lot of them are really cool, so you'll want to check those out. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Catch you in the next video.